Cecil, your dog. I didn't know that you were really going to bring him over tonight.
Sure. That's why I'm a little late. Well, here he is.
Bring him on in the living room and I'll see.
Come on, boy. Come on. Oh.
Where did you get the big rope around his neck, Cecil?
I'm going to get a chain tomorrow. Come on, boy. Get on your feet.
My goodness, but he's big. What makes him so clumsy, Cecil?
Oh, he's not clumsy.
Don't drag him, Cecil. Can't he walk?
Sure he can walk. Come on, boy. Come on. Oh, I'll have to carry him. Come on here.
Oh, Cecil, what a funny-looking dog.
All right. Here we are now. Come on, get on, you dumb mutt.
Cecil, I thought you said he was smart.
He is. Just wait till you see the tricks I taught him.
What's his name, Cecil?
I'm going to call him Nero.
Oh, isn't there a piece of poetry about Nero, my dog has fleas?
I don't know. I think it's a good name. Aunt Beth suggested it.
What was the reason?
Oh, she made a smart crack.
What was it?
She said that it was a good name because he's fat and lazy.
He doesn't play a fiddle, does he?
Well, if he had hands, he could. He's smart enough.
He doesn't look very smart to me.
Good old Nero. Come on, stand up, Nero.
Listen to him beat his tail on the floor.
Look at him look at me. Oh, come on, you old mutt. Attaboy.
Oh, Cecil, don't let him lick your face.
Look, see how he likes me? Look at the look in his eyes. Look at his eyes. Did you ever see such faithful eyes?
Is he really smart?
Smart? Why, he can do anything.
So you're going to keep him?
Like to see someone stop me.
My goodness, what a big tail.
Someone should have cut it off when he was a puppy, but it's too late now.
I'll bet it gets tiresome carrying it around.
He's got good blood in him. You can tell by his ears.
I don't see any blood on his ears.
Oh, I mean the way he holds them. Put up your ears, Nero. Come on.
Cecil, look. He wags his tail. Sways his whole body.
You want to see him do some tricks?
Hadn't you better take that rope off of him first?
Yeah, I guess so. Get up, boy. Come on. Let's get this off.
You ought to buy him a collar as long as you've decided to keep him.
I am, when I can save enough money. Oh, I'm going to fix him up quick. Now, there you are, boy. Didn't like that rope, did you? He didn't like it. That's why he made me drag him instead of walking. That shows how smart he is.
Let's see him do tricks, Cecil.
Well, first I can make him beg for food. Have you got a piece of steak?
No.
Well, I can't make him beg unless I have something to make him beg for.
Well, I think we have some cool spinach out in the icebox.
I wouldn't make even a dog beg for that. Well, I guess I'll have to make him do something else.
Can he walk on his hind feet, Cecil?
Well, not yet. I'm training him now.
I just love to see dogs walk on their hind feet.
I've taught him to carry the newspaper out of the front yard in his mouth. He can fetch it now.
Not really.
Yeah. Get your newspaper and roll it up. Now make him get it for me.
Well, I haven't got a newspaper. Uncle Thomas didn't bring it. He stayed downtown tonight.
Well, how am I going to make him do any tricks if you haven't got anything?
Well, would a magazine do? Could he fetch a magazine in his mouth?
Oh, I don't think so. It's too big. Well, I'll have to make him do something else.
Oh, make him play dad.
All right. Now, Nero, dead dog, dead dog. There, see? See?
Oh, but Cecil, he didn't do anything. He didn't move. He's just lying there on the floor, not moving.
Sure, he's playing dead.
Oh, is that what he's been doing? I thought he was going to sleep.
When I finish training this dog, oh, it's going to be just too bad.
Can you make him go over in the corner and lie down?
Sure. Nero, get up, Nero. Here, come here, I'm talking to you.
He doesn't want to get up, Cecil.
He's not used to this house. Get up, Nero. Go over there in the corner. Come on, lie down.
Maybe he thinks you mean lie down here.